basics muna, you know, go. Kung wala kang basics ng stock market, for example, or mutual funds, tapos gusto mo mabilisan crypto, I think it's the wrong approach. Being a long-term investor, Marvin, it has been such a long time na yung buong portfolio ko green. And that's what's happening now. And I see that, I'm very bullish. I believe that the market will keep on rising.
Now, Brother Bo, I'm so excited to talk about this because I know you ventured above and beyond what's happening in the Philippine markets, and you've gone global in terms of the stock market, and I don't know if a lot of your following know this already, you ventured also in the cryptocurrency. And before we go into a deeper dive, I just want to know, what's the logic and the rationale behind going to those two markets, especially that yun gumagalaw yun kahit tulog tayo?
Yeah, you know, again, it's for diversification. My mentor, his name is Edward Lee. He was the one who introduced me to the stock market. And so he introduced me to the Philippine stock market. Tapos at a certain point, you know, not too long after I got in, he said, oh, mag-diversify ka na. Maglagay ka na ng pera. Put some money in the U.S. stock market. So that's what I did. And then later on, as the years went by, the REITs in Singapore are very, very good. And so I put some money there. I put some money in, you know, one stock maybe in China, another stock, and so different places. And again, I'm a long-term investor. I'm very boring. Right now, the U.S. is hopefully it will go up. We're expecting it to go higher.
What I like, at least from my perspective, is it allows you to be exposed to companies that are disrupting the way we live our lives, and madami doon from what we do, especially from the technology aspect. You're not just investing for what you're using now, you're investing for something that will be used over the next decade, and I think that's what makes it very, very interesting. Similar to my question in the Philippine markets, yung galaw sa US, sobrang volatile. We were talking about Tesla at the start of the year. Nag 900 pa siya at the start of the year. Then it dropped to around 500.
Yes. Are you? My gosh.
Are you deploying the same technique that okay? I like Tesla. It's going. It dropped. I want to have a bigger piece of it while it's down.
Yeah, I kept on buying little by little Tesla when it was going down, and then I stopped. I said, ubos na. Di ba, ganun eh, parang wala na akong bala. So, nanghinayan ako. But, you know, I said, oh, I bought enough already, I'm okay. So, now it's gone up. It's going up again. And very happy for that. Marvin, while you were talking, I realized something. The reason why I like Globe so much was it was one of the strongest technology companies. Kasi because of GCash. That yun lang nag-iisa. Sa US, andami. Andaming mga disruptors, di ba? Tesla, and even the big guys like Facebook and Google, etc. But of course, I was also investing in bio stocks, no? So the edits and all of that. Pero dito sa Pilipinas, GCash ang parang the strongest. So that's why I liked it so much. And true enough, you know, fintech, the strongest fintech company we have is GCash. And so there, it proved right. So pag disruptors talaga, no? Marvin, grabe, exciting.
You mentioned Facebook. I just want to say this. I'm not sure if you heard about the news that Facebook is rebranding itself. They're going to be doing something highly connected to the metaverse already. Everything is everything's digital and online. Parang that's where they want to go. And I think we're going to see more AR, VR, and everything. People living in the digital space over the next decade or so of whatever they're doing. And that's that's Facebook na parang to make a move like that, considering Facebook sila and to rebrand. That's something very interesting.
Wow, amazing, Marvin. Sige, kwentuhan mo pa kami.
I want to ask this. You mentioned about Technology Globe and then yung speed niya to be able to make financial transactions from GCash. What was your reason naman for the cryptocurrency market space? What do you like about it? Kasi for me, it took some time. I first heard about it. I keep telling this to people. First heard about it 2013. Then meron pa akong column sa Rappler. I posted something 2014 na ingat kayo dyan. Kung maglalagay ko, it has to be a small amount of your portfolio. And then at that time, I was saying na ginagamit siya sa smuggling or sa black market. Then after 5 years lang talaga ako na-invest. It took me 5 years to start. Pero small amounts lang. The lockdown lang talaga forced me to study to be able to allocate a larger amount into it. What was it that clicked for you that, teka, this is something that I should consider already. This is something that there's a lot of uncertainty towards it. Not a lot of people understand it, but I think I'm gonna go towards this.
There was this woman, Catherine Wood, ARK Invest. It's I started reading her and watching her videos. She has a fund and it is very popular. ARKK.
ARK Invest.
Tapos mataas yung respeto ko sa kanya. Tapos she was saying that, you know, Bitcoin is here to stay. Crypto is here to stay. Of course, not all the thousands of altcoins. Hindi yun. Pero crypto as a whole, you know, and blockchain is here to stay and so on. So habang nakikinig pa ako sa kanya, tama ka rin. You know, I really got into this not too early. I probably nung the early days of the pandemic or slightly before that, you know, started getting into it. And but you know, Marvin, I still teach people na if you're gonna get into crypto, you put only the amount of money you're willing to lose. You know, that for me is rule number one. For those who are new, kasi pag new ka, wala ka pang alam, di ba? So you're gonna make all sorts of crazy mistakes if you're going to put a lot of money there. So maglagay ka ng konti, and then call it your education fund. Na pag nawala, edi natuto ka. And call it your entertainment fund also. I told my sons when I was getting into it, anak, do you want to get into crypto? You're so young. You should learn. And you know, put your entertainment money there. So every month, instead of buying your video game, you put money there, you know, on a regular basis. And so that's been my approach, Marvin. And one of the things I tell people, if you can put 1% of your net worth, you know, and then just keep on learning. And it's been a good ride, learning from you, Marvin, learning from Rex Mendoza, learning from, you know, we created a small group of people who are interested in it within the Truly Rich Club. It's called blockchaincircle.ph.
Wow.
And it's been a wonderful educational adventure for me, more than anything else, you know. Saying that, Marvin, ang daming napapaso, ang daming nasusunog, they use it as a gambling place, you know, they really gamble. Ang attitude nila is, you know, I want a quick buck, I want to double my money, triple my money, you know, in a snap of a finger. So I'm just cautioning people, you know, don't do it that way, you know, study. You've got to really, really study this. And again, I don't have much time, Marvin, so I'm again trying to be a long-term investor here with Bitcoin and Ethereum. You know, I'm boring again, but I do have a few altcoins thanks to you and Rex Mendoza. So there, it's exciting. It really is exciting. But I keep telling people, please invest in the stock market. Kung basics muna, you know, go. Kung wala kang basics ng stock market, for example, or mutual funds, tapos gusto mo mabilisan crypto, I think it's the wrong approach. I think, you know, learn the basics, learn about patience. You know, Marvin, put it this way, my helper, you know, I always like telling her story. dalawa sila, because I'm so proud of them. You know, Gina, she's not no longer my helper. She's a bookkeeper now. Pinomote ko na siya. Magaling siya. 2 million na ang pera niya.
Wow.
My other helper is 1.5 million. It took them 11 years, di ba? 11 years of discipline, investing in the stock market, the right companies, you know? So I tell people, it's possible, but you need to have the patience. I remember the quote of, maganda yung, di ba, si Bezos was interviewing Warren Buffett, and he was asking, you know, why is it that people don't follow you, your investment system, you know? And sinabi ni Warren, because people don't want to grow rich slowly. Basically, that's it, you know? So Bezos was saying, eh, ang ganda-ganda ng system mo, it's proven, blah, 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 you know? Like, eh, yun eh, mabagal eh. People don't want to grow slowly. So I'm just saying that, yes, you know, please investigate crypto, get into crypto, you know, with your eyes open and study and ganyan-ganyan. But never give up the slow. You know, that okay, crypto is fast money. Let's tanggapin na natin yun. It's fast money. But please, the bulk of your investment should be in slow money. Yun lang. I don't know if I'm too conservative, Marvin, but that's just what I think.
I totally agree, no? And to everyone watching this, this is what I believe, that ano, patience is so underrated, eh, but it's one of the greatest weapons in investing. Eh? Having the patience to put money into something that you're fully convinced in. And that's where Brother Bo said truly makes sense, no? That kung lalagay ka ng pera sa Bitcoin kasi you just want to get rich without actually knowing what it is, because of the volatility, you will be shaken. Eh? To see Bitcoin hit 64,000 last April to drop to 28,000 in just a few weeks. If you don't know what it is, you don't have conviction on how game-changing it is, and daling maratel eh. Tapos lalo na, dagdag mo pa, if you're putting money that kailangan mo or it's not an amount that's tolerable for you, that's where it becomes shaky. That's why the money that you put in, investing into anything should never be about making more. Eh. Parang making more is just a byproduct of how you properly studied and somehow allocated towards it. And very, very well said. And I'm just happy that we're seeing more Filipinos adapt cryptocurrency, especially Bitcoin. I like what you said, that there's other cryptocurrencies, but there are the ones that are really, really big, because when people study it, it's truly game changing. It's something that because not a lot of people understand it yet, there's a lot of fear, but that's where the money also is, eh. Kasi pag naintindihan na ng lahat ng tao yan, mahal na siya, eh. And if there's one thing that I appreciate from what you did, Brother Bo, is that you took the time to also study, but it didn't stop there, but you started to allocate towards it. And then ano siya, eh, parang stocks din naman yan, eh. The more na nasanay ka na, parang mas comfortable na ako. Sige, dagdag. Ano na lang, dagdag. Kasi ganun din sabi ko. 1% lang. 1% lang to ng proportion ng stock market. Tapos later on, I found myself in this dark hole that I just kept on adding. And experience is really the best teacher, that once you're in it already, iba yung nakita mo na bumagsak yung crypto ng 50% versus talagang you saw your portfolio also in a span of a few days go through that. I want to transition to another topic, but if there's one crypto question you'd like to ask me just to end this segment, is there anything that you find fascinating that you would like to know or learn about it as well?
There's what they call the Ethereum killers, diba? Or potential Ethereum replacements. Do you think na talagang mare-replace yung Ethereum? Or so that's the first question. The second question is this: what would be these Ethereum killers na pwedeng na people need to investigate further?
Mm-hmm. Got it. That's a very good question. And that's something hard to answer also, no? But I'll do my best. I'll do my best to be able to give clarity to it. So right now, Bitcoin is number one in terms of market cap, 1.2 trillion. And then Ethereum is number two, pero layo ng gap. Before I address the killers and how it will be, there's a greater theory also that at some point, Ethereum will flip Bitcoin as the number one in terms of market cap, because totoo, Bitcoin is in terms of scarcity so amazing. There will never be more than 21 million Bitcoins ever. However, what makes Ethereum amazing is the network effects. You look at Ethereum like Amazon, that once more people get into it, it becomes a ripple effect, like parang network talaga, net talaga siya, na it just keeps on parang expanding.
And
the applications are in Ethereum. If you go palang to the NFT space, the largest transactions are of Ethereum. The artists are in Ethereum. The users are also in Ethereum as well. That being said though, ito yung nagiging issue ng Ethereum killers. The problem with Ethereum sa cryptocurrencies kasi there's three things that it does it. It's secure, it's decentralized, and then it allows you to send it in lightning fast speeds. Yung problem sa Ethereum is because it's yung mechanism niya parang Bitcoin, it uses proof of work. Yung issue niya is it's not scalable. And then they're upgrading to Ethereum 2.0. Yung problem doon is what people don't see, it's so hard to do that because unlike all of the other Ethereum killers, kumbaga, they were able to launch everything from the start.
Yeah.
What Ethereum is doing is parang open heart live surgery, or parang lumilipad ng eroplano tapos inaayos mo yung eroplano habang lumilipad.
Ooh. So
there's the concern there that they might not pull it off, it might be delayed, or while they're trying to pull it off, there are others that could get adoption. Yung problem is also in favor of Ethereum. The reason why mabagal Ethereum, the reason why hindi siya scalable, the reason why mahal yung mga transaction fees is nandun lang ang issues eh. It hasn't happened yet to all of the other
Ethereum
killers as well eh. There's not a lot of traction. There's the number of applications that are in those other networks versus Ethereum, hindi ganun kadami. Tapos ayun, yung users wala pa. Hindi pa siya ganun kadami. So to answer your second question, which would be probably the Ethereum killers. I'd put five into the mix. Polkadot, Solana, Algorand, Avalanche, and Cardano. Between the five, there's a lot of attention towards Solana because of NFTs. The NFTs in Solana over some period of time, there was a stretch na sobrang laki ng transactions na NFTs doon. And ako ganun yung tinitingnan ko eh. I look at not just the technology, pero ano yung madaling gamitin ng tao? Because kung madali siyang gamitin ng tao, doon pumapasok yung network effect niya na pinag-usapan natin earlier. That's why I'll say this. A lot of these Ethereum killers also, wala pa talagang applications that's being used by a lot of people. That's why I want to segment to how interesting Axie Infinity is, because may users eh, may use case eh. People could say whatever they want about it, but it's not just anymore a token of the future. It's something that people are actually using and transacting in also today. So yun, I think Ethereum might be beaten, but because of the underlying risks that I've mentioned. Pero if Ethereum 2.0 pulls it off, there's a bigger chance that it flips Bitcoin. So yun, but dun sa list, I think I like Solana.
Cheap insurance, small amount of money, you can be insured against dengue, against COVID, tapos income replacement pa. Tapos umpisa pa lang yan. There will be other products. And then you can do it from your phone, so accessible. What is there not to be excited, you know, to see that it's now so accessible for the common person to say, hey, I need this as protection.